The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a...
You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
All writers are prone to becoming so attached to our characters and stories that we struggle to see why a passage may not be working. It takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing to full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, shaping stories into masterpieces that can stand the test of time. Editing services are provided for all genres and all age categories. Services range from critiques of the short story through to the line edits of the full-length novel and copy editing for those preparing for publication. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your website, as well as help with those book blurbs and promotional material. We won't abandon you to the masses. We want to celebrate with you and your successes. Black Wolf Editorial Services, nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services and prices, visit us at blackwolfeditorial.com.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Hey, folks. I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Harden. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at raharden.com. That's the World Wide Web at raharden.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Harden to see and purchase his books.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it. There to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Well, hello, America. Good evening. This is Rick Robinson. You are listening to America Off the Rails. We're coming to you live right now on KLRNradio.com. Also on CRNTalk.com, and also this episode will be heard tomorrow on Red Nation Rising Radio. So if you're listening to us right now, that means it is Sunday night, and it means it's either 7 p.m. Pacific if you're listening to us on CRN, or 11 p.m. Eastern if you're listening to us on KLRNTalk.com. We've got a lot of show for you tonight. We're going to be talking some election aftermath, some recaps. We're going to have a visit from a former co-host of mine, Mr. Dave Brown from Finding Common Ground. Some of you may remember him if you've been hanging out with us for a while, back on our days from K98 Talk as well as Common Ground Media Network. We've been together now for quite some time, been really good friends, even though he is a raging liberal. We're going to have him on for the last half of the show, talking aftermath and more. But first, of course, we're going to spend most of the show talking about the crazy bedwetting liberals and the overreaction from the right, because it's all over the place right now. So everything's just gone a little bit crazy. So buckle in, hang tight. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson. Don't go away.
It's time to hear the truth about America's biggest challenges. You're listening to America Off the Rails with your host, Rick Robinson.
Listen, folks, I'm here to tell you our political system is broken. The two-party system is dead. They have become one and the same.
Keep on doing what you do, Rick. You're my favorite host.
Favorite host.
And in a surprising and disturbing move today, the Libertarian vice presidential candidate just agreed that rifles are weapons of mass destruction, and people on the terror watch list should not be allowed to purchase guns. So in other words, the party of freedom is liberty for me, but not for thee.
Compromise where you can. Where you can't, don't. Even if everyone is telling you that something wrong is something right, even if the whole world is telling you to move, it is your duty to plant yourself like a tree.
All right, folks, so as I said, it's been an interesting week. I guess this is Sunday, so now it's the beginning of a new week. So let's say last week was an interesting week. We watched the left go on a complete meltdown. We've now started to see the beginnings of a potential right meltdown on the right, because all of these news stories are coming out now about things that President-elect Trump might actually be walking back on. I have been never Trump from the beginning. Now, that has changed, and I'm catching a lot of flack for that, because, look, at this point, he is going to be the president. I had grounds to fight him as long as he was either a candidate or the nominee, because he wasn't the president yet. But he is going to be the president now. but I'm catching flack from all sides now because I'm trying to afford him the same courtesy that I gave to Barack Obama, even if I fought him every step of the way as well, too, which is, let's see what he does after he gets sworn in, because right now it's all rhetoric. Right now he's trying to find ways to calm people down, so he may be saying things on both sides that he may not necessarily agree with. So I don't know, because at this point we have special snowflakes on the left that are bringing college campuses to a screeching halt. Nobody can hold classes because they've been having pizza specially ordered and brought in, grief counselors on hand. We've had HuffPo posting suicide hotline numbers at the bottom of their election coping articles. And it's completely insane and crazy. All right. So at this point, we are about to have to take a break. When we come back, I have a clip I've put together of some of the whining from the left, just for fun, and then we'll actually start picking on the right again, because you know me, I take shots at everybody every chance I get. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson. We will be right back.
I've owned my company for 14 years now, and I can tell you that payroll is a four-letter word. I hate doing it. It eats up hours I don't have, and it costs me money I could be saving. But my accountant's too expensive, and I'm not sure who to call. But I know I need help.
We're Paychex, and we take all the hassles out of small business payroll. We save you time and money. It's easy. Call, fax, or give us your payroll information securely online, and we take care of the rest. We calculate the correct taxes, manage payments and direct deposits. We even send out your checks. Payroll doesn't need to be a four-letter word anymore. We're so sure that we can save you time and money that we'll give you a month's payroll free. Just for calling 877-757-2782. Get 1 month's payroll for free. Call Paychex right now. 877-757-2782. That's 877-757-2782.
All right, folks, welcome back. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson. We are going to continue with the aftermath of the election. So, you know, we've had some pretty special snowflakes, including a former CNN cameraman, and not to mention Miley Cyrus going a little crazy over the Hillary loss. So we decided to have a little bit of fun with it. Here we go.
I was all right. For a while, I could smile for a while. But I saw you last night, you held my hand so tight as you stopped to say hello. Boy, you wished me well, you couldn't tell that I've been crying.
How did he win fair and square? Hillary had more votes. More human beings voted for Hillary. This isn't fair. We didn't get one vote. You didn't get a vote. It's just like back in the day when your vote was one third. Just count the votes. It's ridiculous. Hillary, you're a lawyer. Walk in, go to the Supreme Court. I believe in you, Hillary. I've been to Rwanda. I've been to your hospital in Rwanda. I've seen all the good you've done. I believe in you. Women need you. Minorities need you. I need you. Chicago needs you. We all need you. This country needs you to stand up and walk into the Supreme Court and say one vote equals one vote. What's wrong with that?
Most people are against you. Well, maybe not, because given the result, maybe I really am different, and maybe a lot of people that I'm surrounded by think with open minds and open hearts like I do. And I do want to say that I've been very vocal for my support for everyone besides Donald Trump. Heavily supported Bernie, heavily supported Hillary, and I still think that in her lifetime she deserves to be the first female president. And that's what makes me so sad, is that I just wish that she had that opportunity because she's fought for so long, and because I believe her when she says that she loves this country. This is all she's ever done. She's given her life to make it better. but like Donald Trump so ironically played after his speech, that said you can't always get what you want. And happy hippies.
The resounding answer to that is yes, at some point I would love to see a female president of the United States, but apparently really not one as corrupt and as criminally negligent as Hillary Clinton was. Because let's not forget, the FBI decided there had to be intent for the charges that they were looking at, and the U.S. Code of Statutes didn't mention intent for the law they were actually specifically looking at to see if she broke. And that is the irony of this, folks, when you really stop and think about it. And it's why, even though I have been opposed to Donald Trump this entire time, I am actually taking this a lot better than even I expected, because the meltdown of the left has been delicious. Because, look, this is not a victory lap, I promise. But one of the things that I've noticed is, because, you know, I mentioned that in the next couple segments, we're going to have Dave Brown, one of the former hosts of Finding Common Ground, on with me. Well, when his job schedule changed, because at that time we were still kind of doing all of this as a hobby, we found a millennial who was a leftist or a leftist-leaning person who actually assumed the left chair when Dave could no longer do the live broadcast on Saturdays. But the thing with that is, this young man is now 18. He's in college. But he spent the last 8 years of his life watching the country slide more and more left as far as he was concerned. And I don't think he ever meant it in a truly hateful way or a hurtful way, but he kept telling me every chance he could on Finding Common Ground that I was a dying breed, that the country was moving another direction, because he had seen nothing but the pendulum going to the left. And that's the part that I tried to explain to him now for the couple of years that he's been with us, is this is a pendulum action. Once it swings too far to the left, it always corrects itself. The problem that we have is nobody finds a way to try to keep the pendulum at the center. They go too far left, too far right, and then there always has to be a correction. This was the correction. We knew it was happening at some point. We just honestly really hoped it wasn't going to happen under Trump. And look, I have to say, at this point, again, I'm being cautiously optimistic. He's going to be president one way or the other. There's absolutely nothing that I'm going to be able to do about that. So I am going to give him the benefit of the doubt until such time as he's sworn in and starts actually being able to enact his policies. And then if he doesn't do the things that he said he was going to do, and if the Congress and the Senate that he now can at this point, the Republican Party controls all three facets of the federal government. Those being, of course, the Congress, which is made up of the House and the Senate, which they now have full control of. The executive branch, which I'm actually technically a libertarian now, because the Libertarian Party actually retained ballot access in Oklahoma. So they have control of the House and the Senate. They've managed to maintain that. They will have control of the executive branch, and because of that, they will have the ability to shape the third branch, which is the judicial, through the Supreme Court. Now, all of these, in my opinion, are actually good things if we can get conservative policies enacted. Now, I've already started to see what appears to be a possible impending meltdown from some more ardent Trump supporters, because, again, they're reacting to things that are being said, rumors that are being floated, and they're not happy because all of a sudden he's apparently maybe walking back the idea of the special prosecutor for Hillary. Look, I have to say, I was kind of opposed to that to begin with, because, one, it's not really going to accomplish anything at this point. I mean, as much as I would love to see her in an orange jumpsuit, do we really need to spend the money on it? Everybody knows she's guilty. I mean, yeah, she's walking free and other folks that have done much lesser offenses aren't, so I can kind of see that perspective. But at the same time, I don't necessarily like the idea that a presidential candidate was telling another presidential candidate that if he got elected, she was going to go to jail. That's not ultimately his decision to make. So if once he's in control, if someone else decides to pick it up and bring in a special prosecutor, I don't necessarily have an issue with that. But threatening to jail one's opponents is not how this country is run, and it shouldn't ever be how this country is run. Now, a lot of folks that were on my side of the argument are now a little afraid of that, though, because, of course, there's rumors that he's walking back the special prosecutor for Hillary, but those of us that were, and some that still are, never Trump, are now apparently going to wind up on some form of watch list. But the thing that needs to remain specifically in everyone's mind at this point is most of these things that you're hearing, they're not coming from the man himself. They're coming from surrogates. They're coming from people that may or may not even have the authority to speak for him. So what I'm asking for at this point is just that we all take a second and chill out. Look, I don't care if you're on the left. I don't care if you're on the right. I don't care if you're down the center. I don't care if you voted for whoever you thought was going to have pink purple with polka dot underwear on. I don't really care at this point. The election is over. We have to come back together. We have to find a way back to each other. And that's why I got so mad, and we'll probably talk about this a little more later in the show, when I got so mad about when I started hearing all the people on the right, all the pundits and the big political heads talking about, well, who cares about unity? We won. We should destroy them. Look, folks, we can't keep doing things this way. Somebody has to decide to stand up and be an adult. But believe it or not, we are nearly up to a break, so I'm going to go ahead and wind things down for just a second. When we come back, we've got one other stab I want to take, and then we'll have a guest on for most of the rest of the show. Of course, this next clip will take up most of the next segment. It is a clip that I heard that discussed a lot of things to do with Newt Gingrich and his stance on Never Trump.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hey folks, I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Hardin. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at rahardin.com. That's the World Wide Web at rahardin.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Hardin to see and purchase his books.
All right, folks, welcome back. This is America Off the Rails, and as promised, we're going to take the stab at the right, because, you know, at this point, I kind of disagree with all of them, and this is another thing that has had me really annoyed over the last few days. This is a recent interview between Sean Hannity and Newt Gingrich, and Newt Gingrich, well, I'll let you hear what he had to say, because I disagree with it quite vehemently.
Joining us now, best-selling author of the new book Treason, former Speaker of the House, Fox News contributor, big smile on his face, Newt Gingrich. There was a part of me today that really wanted to name names of those Republicans, those. All right, you're going to show yourself the bigger man. But I resisted the temptation to name names. All those people that sabotaged him were not helpful, did everything to hurt him. And frankly, if they were successful, would be beating people like you and me over the head with a baseball bat and saying, oh, see, they were all wrong the whole time. But I didn't do it. Aren't you proud of me?
Right. I'm very proud of you. I think it's a sign of your newfound post-victory maturity.
All right. What
look,
do you,
I mean,
go ahead.
Let me just say this because we've known each other so long. You and I, along with millions of other Americans, are just beginning one of the great adventures of our lifetime. The 8 years of Donald Trump are going to be among the most extraordinary, creative, inventive, exciting periods in all of American political history, and will, I think, both move America back to being great again, dramatically drain the swamp in Washington, and move our systems into the 21st century to provide much, much better experiences for every American. Now, my only point is, compared to all that, the little whiny, sniveling, negative cowards who were never Trumpers are beneath our paying attention to them. Let them drift off into the ashbin of history while we go ahead and work with Donald Trump and with the House and Senate Republicans to create a dramatically new future.
Do you believe the old order Republican Party? I believe it's dead. And there's a new Republican Party, and hopefully one that's revitalized with bold color differences, as President Reagan talked about. Do you worry about those old guard Republican establishment people eventually, as quickly as they can, turning on Trump and stopping progress that he's laid out and I think got a mandate for last night?
Look, their technique won't be to turn on him. I remember this both with Reagan in 81, 82, and then with us once we got a majority in 94. Their technique will be to say, oh, be reasonable. Don't push too hard. Don't force the issue. Find a compromise with Democrats. Maybe he shouldn't name one of the justices who are conservative who's on his list. Maybe he should find a nice, moderate, acceptable to the Democrats. Down that road is a disaster. And so we have to be aware that the danger is not that they're going to actively fight. The danger is that they're going to offer honeyed words of subversion that undermines the entire movement to make America great again, undermines the entire Trump movement, which is beginning to change America. But I have a hunch, just based on today's conversations, we were in Charleston now, we're talking to you from Atlanta, and as I talk to people all around the place, one, lots of people walked up and said congratulations, including people who are for Hillary. They said, look, you guys won a great campaign, and we just respect that you did it. Two, there is a spirit here of what if we could actually come together to get big things done. Now, that doesn't mean backing off on anything, but I would suggest to you, for example, that a really dramatic infrastructure program will get at least half the Democrats to sign up for it and be exactly in the job-creating direction that Donald Trump has talked about for a year and a half. So there are ways to build the next 6 months that it becomes a really pretty remarkable majority-building project that sets the stage for greater economic growth, greater take-home pay on terms that Trump has campaigned on.
All right, so I have a question for Mr. Gingrich, because as you heard there in about the middle of that, he started talking about how he hoped Never Trump would be relegated to the ashbin of history. So is that every single Never Trumper, or is that just the ones that are still screaming that they won't support him? Because at this point, there are honestly Never Trump folks on both sides. I was a conservative Never Trumper, which honestly made me Never Hillary first. I just couldn't see a valid way for either one of them to be either a good president or the best choice for the country, and I still agree with that statement, because I do not think he is the best choice for the country, but he is the decision that America made. So much like I did in 2008, instead of screaming how things are not fair and going to burn things down and rioting and protesting, etc., I'm going to have to be a big boy, put my big boy pants on, and try to work with this new president-elect Donald Trump. Because again, I did not support him all the way through the process. Well, except for maybe in about the first month, and we've talked about that before. But when I come back, we have a guest with us,
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hey folks, I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Hardin. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at rahardin.com. That's the World Wide Web at rahardin.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Hardin to see and purchase his books.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Having a place to go after school will make you a better student. Having an outlet to express yourself will make you a better artist. Having something to do together will make you a better family. At The Y, we're helping build better friends, listeners, writers, swimmers, scientists, and musicians one chance at a time. Give the gift of opportunity. Support the Y at ymca.net. The Y, for a better us.
All right, folks, welcome back. This is America Off the Rails right here on KLRNradio.com and CRNTalk.com. Now, right now, I have a guest joining me, Mr. Dave Brown. You may remember him for folks that have followed along with me throughout the years. He used to be the left chair co-host of Finding Common Ground. He's actually joining me for this segment of the show so we can get a liberal perspective on the election aftermath. Good evening,
hey,
sir.
How's it going? Thank you for having me on.
Not a problem. All right, so the next segment is pretty much yours. We have about 8 minutes, so we got to take a break. So why don't you go ahead and fill folks in on some of your takes, both before, during, and after the election, since you haven't been on. Well, actually, I don't think you've ever been on this show.
Usually you avoid
this show like the plague.
Yeah, true. I was on once a long time ago, back in the old home, and I haven't been on in a while. So this whole election was just this was a poop show from day one, and it was just you almost don't even know where to begin, you know, because it was so just bad. Even at the very beginning, when we had these 17, 18, 20 some odd candidates between the two major parties. And even at that point, you know, with the exception of a couple of individuals here and there, you're looking at this thing going, this is the best we got? Really? This? And then it comes down to, oh, poo sandwich A or barf soup B. Which do you prefer? They both suck. And and the rhetoric was so bad, mostly from a certain orange-haired and orange-skinned individual. In a lot of ways, I'm at a loss for words. One thing I think that kind of illustrates how crazy this election was. So on election day, I work at a public library, and the branch that I work at, we happen to also be a polling station. And so parking that day sucked because our parking isn't very good to begin with. So that was not fun. But toward the end of the day, I'm sitting at the desk and this girl comes in who's probably a sixth grader. She's a regular. There's a school across the street. The kids come after school all the time. And so she asked me, who did you vote for? And immediately I'm like, oh, God, I don't want this conversation. And so my first reaction was, I voted for lots of people. Yeah. And then so she, you know, pushed. And of course, I'm thinking to myself, this is really inappropriate. I totally should not answer this question, especially with this kid. But then there's my gut reaction of just answering questions as I'm asked them and to be truthful. Damn, that sucks sometimes. So I looked at her. I'm like, are you going to hold it against me? And she goes, no. Like, I voted for Hillary. And she bangs her head on her hand on the counter and yells, Hillary! I was like, oh, okay, chick, you need to calm your butt down.
So much for not holding it against you.
Yeah, yeah. First of all, you're holding it against me. Second of all, you're in sixth grade. You don't know anything. You need to slow your roll. And that was perfectly kind of summed up the election. And so election night, I'm watching with the family. We watched pretty much all of the debates. There was one that I just couldn't watch, mostly because there was a WWE pay-per-view on. And I have a wrestling podcast that I host or co-host, and I needed to watch that. So I was like, screw this. I'm just going to go watch something actually entertaining. So we watch all the debates, we watch the election coverage, and as the night goes on, and it's looking more and more like Trump's going to win, and my son is following, like, the New York Times had this probability thing on their site that's like, okay, as the night went on, it kept going, 86% chance Trump's going to win, 90% chance Trump's going to win, over 95% chance Trump's going to win. And at the point they called Florida, I was like, screw this, I'm going to bed. So I got up the next day, found out Donald Trump won. I was like, huh, well, that's crazy. But I wore black to work in the morning. And actually, so did a couple of my coworkers. Not planned at all. And three of us showed up in black. You know, it is what it is, man. I'm heartened by the speech that Trump gave that night, his acceptance speech, before he went off on his very weird tangent of thanking people, which he kind of sounded half drunk during, but I digress. But the speech itself, the meat of it was actually good. He was talking about bringing people together and whatnot. Hillary's concession speech the next day was quite good. Barack Obama's speech about the situation and talking about how he's going to work with the Trump folks to make sure there's a smooth transition, and how he praised President Bush and his team. That made me feel better about the situation. Then stuff started to hit the fan, and you start seeing things on Twitter like day one in Trump's America. You see crazy crap going on. Then you see people protesting and destroying property. Then you got this whole not my president movement and all this nonsense. Well, 8 years ago when Barack Obama won and people like Rush Limbaugh were saying he's not my president, I hope he fails, that was stupid. And it's stupid now when people on the other side are saying this guy is not my president, I hope he fails. He's the captain of the ship that we are all in. If he fails, the ship sinks and we're screwed. So if nothing else, for simple self-preservation, we should never want any president to fail. We may not agree with their policies. Fine. We may not like them as a person from what we can tell, because how many of us have actually met these people? Not many. So yeah, the whole thing is crazy. And I worry that, you know, with the wrong spark, it's going to all blow up and it's going to get really ugly. My hope is that it's just a period of people expressing disappointment, and people express disappointment in different ways. And folks need to get off their high horses. The people who are upset that Hillary lost need to get off their high horse and just understand, I'm disappointed that my team lost, and just suck it up and deal with it. The people on the other side who are saying things like, well, when Obama won, we didn't protest. No, that's actually inaccurate. You did. Tea Party protests, the aforementioned Limbaugh and the ilk talking their craziness. It did happen. So it's on the one hand, I guess it's good for the goose.
I think in all fairness, as we're coming up on the break, I think it's right to say that the anti-Obama crowd did protest, but I don't really remember anybody having a riot. So I think the language choice is wrong, because I think we did actually protest. I don't remember ever saying that he wasn't my president. At least I hope I didn't. But anyway, folks, we are coming up to a break. We have got to take a break. Pay some bills. We'll be right back right here on America Off the Record.
I've owned my company for 14 years now, and I can tell you that payroll is a four-letter word. I hate doing it. It eats up hours I don't have, and it costs me money I could be saving. But my accountant's too expensive, and I'm not sure who to call. But I know I need help.
We're Paychex, and we take all the hassles out of small business payroll. We save you time and money. It's easy. Call, fax, or give us your payroll information securely online, and we take care of the rest. We calculate the correct taxes, manage payments and direct deposits. We even send out your checks. Payroll doesn't need to be a four-letter word anymore. We're so sure that we can save you time and money that we'll give you a month's payroll free. Just for calling 877-757-2782. Get 1 month's payroll for free. Call Paychex right now. 877-757-2782. That's 877-757-2782.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
All right, folks, welcome back. And we did have Mr. Dave Brown with us throughout the break, so he's still with us, and we're still talking election aftermath. Now, again, I kind of want to back up a little bit because I've actually been railing on the right still myself, because one of the things that really drove me crazy was the day after the election when in 2008, when I heard Rush Limbaugh railing about the fact that right after Obama's inauguration, when he brought the Republicans up to the Hill and said, screw you guys, elections have consequences, I won. Rush railed about that for weeks, and day one, not even before Trump is inaugurated, day one that he wins the election, he's like, screw all you liberals, elections have consequences, we won. And it goes back to the same thing that I've been talking about now for quite some time. At some point, somebody involved in this process has to stand up and be an adult. So far, I'm not seeing very many adults in the room.
No, and that's a natural human reaction. Sadly, it's a bad reaction, and it's one that people shouldn't be doing because they get pissed when someone does it to them. And as my children will tell you, they get sick of me saying it. But if you don't want it done to you, don't do it to someone else. So, and Rush Limbaugh is a blowhard anyway. It's sad. He is such a good broadcaster. This is something fascinating, I think, about just a little side thing. I don't like football. I really don't. But when Rush Limbaugh, who I don't particularly like, talks about football, it is riveting, man. I can listen to that crap. Don't know half of what he's talking about or the specific names. I understand football and all that stuff, but I don't know the names of the people or anything. But man, he's good at his job. That having been said, he is so wrong about this behavior. And on the flip side, all the people on the left who are calling that, saying the Democrats need to be obstructionists now, no, 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 please no. We can't take any more of this crap. Trump needs to learn from Obama's biggest mistake, which you mentioned just a second ago, which was saying, I won, suck it. He needs to be humble, which I know that's hard to believe could ever happen, but you know, let's hope. And he needs to call on people for counsel and advice, and he needs to be inclusionary. And that doesn't mean he agrees with everything. That means he talks to people and works out compromises. And there's nothing wrong with that. I don't understand why that has become such an ugly word for both sides in this day and age. So that he needs to learn from the mistakes of Barack Obama. The Democrats need to learn from the mistakes of the Republican Party and not be obstructionists for the next 4 years, because it's not going to work. It's just awful. And we just can't have that. And just like you said, Ricky, be adults, man. Y'all are grown ass men and women. Act like it.
Couldn't have said it any better myself. At this point, I just want to kind of get just a little bit of an overview feeling for you right now, because you'd mentioned at this point you're trying to be cautiously optimistic. At this point, so am I. It's actually one of the reasons why I'm catching flack again from all sides, because for those of you who don't know, I was firmly in the Never Trump camp, still pretty much there, but the issue is he is now going to be president-elect regardless. It's time to try to be an adult, because I fought him tooth and nail for as long as I could, even refusing to give him my vote in the primary or the general, but I felt my vote was better served in Oklahoma, because as you know, all 77 counties went red anyway, by making sure that the Libertarian Party was able to maintain ballot access. So I was one of the folks for the tipping point there, because now we have three parties in the state, at least for the next 2 years. So all of that being said, I'm now still catching flack on all sides, because I'm one of the ones that's now calling for unity. We have folks, and there was an audio clip I played before you came on the show that talked about Newt Gingrich telling the Never Trump crowd to basically go away and crawl in a hole. We don't need you anymore. And it's just one of those things where there are a lot of us that were Never Trump and still kind of are, but he's going to be POTUS now. So we're trying to give Trump at least the respect that the office deserves until we figure out what he's actually going to do, which is what a lot of us on my side of the argument even did with Obama, because we didn't know what we were going to get with Obama. He was a pretty unknown quantity for everybody at that point. So we listened to his speech. We heard what he said. We gave him a shot, realized he wasn't going to do most of what he said he was going to do, so I've been opposed to him ever since. But I've never once said that he wasn't my president. I've said I wished he wasn't my president, but it doesn't change the fact that he was.
Yeah, it's... I will say one of the things that has... As I'm trying to be hopeful, one thing that is concerning to me is the fact that Newt Gingrich is quite possibly going to be Secretary of State. And that's because he is such an authoritarian. Now, that doesn't mean that he will be running the show. I mean, you never know how things are going to work out. And, you know, Trump does have to surround himself with people who have, A, been his supporters, and B, know actually how the system works. And so, you know, Newt Gingrich does know how the system works, scary as he may be. But I don't know. I felt really bad for you as a friend, because I know that you have gotten flack from everyone throughout this entire process. And whenever there are people that have said, you know, that Republicans don't do this and that, Republicans, conservatives don't threaten people who disagree with them, I'm like, oh, really? You need to go talk to my friend Ricky, because he's getting hate mail and death threats on a daily basis for not falling in line and being a good little soldier boy. And so for that, I applaud you, because I know it's not hard. And I'm someone, one of the reasons why, even though we disagree in a lot, I think we get along really well, is I'm someone that I'm an equal opportunity critic, and I get crap from all ends. When I used to write a lot about politics, I got hate mail. Well, not hate mail, but I used to get nasty comments on my blog from, you know, liberals and conservatives telling me how stupid I am.
I want to try to squeeze in a chance, though, for you to mention your podcast that you talked about at the opening of the first segment you were on with me.
Yes, it's Around the Ring Wrestling Podcast, hosted by myself and my friend Floyd Johnson. The show goes up on Sundays. You can hear it here on KLRN at some point in Sundays after we post it. You can find us online, Twitter, Facebook, at Around the Ring OK, and the website is roundtheringok.wordpress.com. You can also check out my blog, where I talk about music and lots of cool stuff, OklahomaLefty.com, and you can follow me on all the social medias at OklahomaLefty. Thank you, Ricky, as always. It's a pleasure coming on. You're a great man, and I'm amazed at the work that you do here on a daily basis, so my hat's off to you.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hey folks, I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Harden. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at rahardin.com. That's the World Wide Web at rahardin.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Hardin to see and purchase his books.
All right, folks, we are back. Believe it or not, we are almost out of time. Now, never fear, we'll be back with you before you know it. But I just want to take a moment just to calm down, ask for just a little bit of sanity. Because, look, like we've been talking about this entire show, nobody's happy at this point. There are plenty of people that didn't want Donald Trump. There are plenty of people that wanted Hillary Clinton. So we have a vast segment of the country that nobody got what they wanted, which last I checked was kind of usually the end game of politics, because usually if everybody walks away unhappy, then usually it's a sign that things maybe kind of went the way they were supposed to. Now, I don't know, because only time will tell, but all I can do at this point is ask that everyone take a deep breath, no matter which side of the argument you were on. Even if you were still firmly in the Never Trump camp, just take a deep breath. Look, I understand the feeling that we have all been under for the last 8 years as we watched the country slide further and further left, feeling like there was nothing that we could do, because no matter what we tried to do, even though we kept sending in conservative people to Congress, all they could really do was put on the brakes, which means they did what they were supposed to do. Just like Dave and I were talking about just a few minutes ago, the government is designed to move slowly, because this big of a country and that big of an undertaking cannot turn on a dime. It's why the idea for direct democracy never works except for in small instances. Look at the country of Greece. They used to be independent city-states that all worked as a direct democracy. It works in small groups. It's no different than communism. Communism is a great idea on paper if you are someone who thinks that everybody should get a fair shake and a fair share. And I have to say, when I was younger, I kind of looked at it too, but that was mainly because I grew up watching things like Star Trek, and it looked like socialism was going to be the way to get us to things like that. I don't know whether it will or it won't, and I don't know what the future holds. What I know is that President-elect Donald Trump has not even been sworn into office yet, and we have people burning down things, breaking things, rioting in the streets, saying he's not my president. And look, just like Dave and I talked about, yes, the right did protest when Barack Obama, when we realized that he was not going to be the great uniter that he claimed that he was going to be. But we didn't burn things down. We didn't riot in the streets. Now, I don't know if some of these more angered right-leaning folks might not, if all of these stories that are coming out now about Donald Trump maybe not doing some of the things that he was apparently sent to DC to do, if he continues to try to move everybody back towards the center, he may lose some of his folks, and I don't know how they're going to react. But again, that is a problem for another day. Right now, the fact is we have a conservative Congress, a conservative executive branch, or we will have in January, and we now have the ability to affect policy change by making sure that conservative judges fill vacancies that come up in the Supreme Court. And those are all very good things. It's one of the reasons why I have been, at this point, relegated to the fact that I have to at least try to support Donald Trump until such time as he proves to me that I cannot. And right now, everything that he is saying is words. He has had no actions, no direct impacts yet, so I have to give him the benefit of the doubt. I have to. And I'm asking each and every one of you, even those of you that were staunchly Never Trump like me, especially of the conservative-leaning Never Trumps, which were also Never Hillary, at this point, at least we got one thing that we want. The Hillary Clinton machine has been stopped. At this point, she's no longer going to be able to trade money for speeches, for special play and special favors throughout the government. That has been stopped. Now, what remains to be seen is what Donald Trump does with the baton that is being passed to him, and rather surprisingly, as Dave mentioned, fairly civilly from Barack Obama, which honestly even surprised me. But at this point, folks, we are officially out of time. I want to remind you each and every day where you can find me, and that's Sunday through Thursday on America Off the Rails on KLRNradio.com at 11 p.m. Eastern. That is also every Saturday and Sunday on CRNTalk.com. At 7 Pacific, 9 Eastern. And we are also on Red Nation Rising Radio every Monday through Friday. And many other outlets that I can't really think of off the top of my head right now. You guys have a great rest of your night. Take care. God bless.
Game over, man! It's game over!
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.